the mirror. We shall discuss about the mirror. Any polished surface that reflects the light is called a mirror. Any polished surface that reflects the light is called a mirror. Generally, while making a mirror, they are taking a glass plate. One side is highly polished. Second side is coated with opaque paint. That paint may be silver oxide paint. Therefore, whatever the surface which is polished, it is the reflecting surface. Now, any polished surface that reflects the light is called mirror. Now, mirrors are two types. First one, plane mirror. Second one, what to say? Curved mirror. Plane mirror and the curved mirror. Now these curved mirrors are two types. Right? Now, concave mirror. Next one, convex mirror. Next, we shall discuss about the plane mirror. Now, in the case of plane mirror, what are the image properties? Now, any polished plane surface is called plane mirror. Now, let us consider this is the plane, this is the plane mirror. Now, this is called, what to say, object, right? Where is the image? Now, the light ray from the object is traveling normally. Now, whenever it is traveling along the normally, the angle of incidence is zero. Angle of incidence is zero, angle of reflection is also zero. Therefore, it retraces back. Now, there is a second light ray. That second light ray is traveling like this. Right? Now, this is called, what to say, point of incidence. At the point of incidence, we want to draw a normal. Now, this is called, what to say, angle of incidence. Now, this is the angle of reflection. And what to say, this is the reflected ray. In the diagram, this is the incident ray. This is the reflected ray. This is the second incident ray. This is the second reflected ray. How the reflected rays are like this. As the reflected rays are diverged, extend back. As the reflected rays are diverged, therefore they should extend back. Now this point is called, what to say, image. This image is formed due to the divergence of reflected rays, thereby it is called, what to say, virtual image. Now, second one. Suppose the same mirror, this is the mirror. Suppose this is the incident ray, These are called, what to say, incident rays. First incident ray. Right? This is the incident ray falling on the mirror. Now, the incident rays are converged. As the incident rays are converged, this is the incident ray extension. Now, this is called, what to say, an object. This is called a virtual object. Now, This is called incident ray. It is falling here. It is called, what to say, normal. Now this is called angle of incidence. Now this is the angle of reflection. Now reflected ray is like this. Now here, this is called incident ray. Now this is called normal. Now this is called angle of incidence. Now this is called angle of reflection. Now this is the reflected ray. This is the reflected ray. Now incident ray, reflected ray. Incident ray, reflected ray. Now reflected rays are going to intersect here. Right? Now the reflected rays are really intersected. This is called, what to say, real image. Therefore, the incident rays are diverged. Then this is called a real object. This is called real object. Now this is called virtual image. In the case of mirror, real object can form virtual image. Otherwise, virtual object can form, that is, real image. Both are possible. Real object can form virtual image. Virtual object can form a real image. Next one. What are the right properties? Properties of image. What are the properties of image in the case of plane mirror? First one, object distance is equals to image distance. Second one, object size is equals to image size. Third one, right, image will undergo lateral inversion. Image will undergo lateral inversion. Next, fourth one, right, the plane mirror magnification is equals to, what to say, plus one. That is, magnification plus one means, that is, now magnification is positive, it will represent the virtual image. Magnification is 1 is 1 means object size is equals to image size. Fifth one, right? Now let us consider this is the mirror. This is the mirror. Now let us consider this is called object. Object is displaced by X. Object is displaced by X. Then image is also displaced by X. Mirror is fixed. Object is moved by X distance. Image is also moved by X distance in opposite direction. If the object is moving with X meter per second, then image is also moving with X meters per second. Right, as the mirror is fixed, object is moved by X distance, image is also moved by X distance in opposite direction. Object is traveling with X meters per second, image is also moving with X meters per second. Sixth property. Now this is the mirror. This is the mirror. Now this is the object. Now object is fixed. If the mirror is moving by X meters per second, if the mirror is moving with X meters per second, then image is moving with 2X meters per second. By keeping the object constant, if the mirror moves by X meters per second, image moves by 2X meters per second. That is seventh property. Now this is the mirror. This is the mirror. Now this is the object. Now object. Object is moving with X meters per second. Right? Object is moving with X meters per second. Then mirror is also moving with X meters per second. Right? Now that is, image is moving with 3X meters per second. 3X meters per second. First of all, in this case, mirror is fixed. Object shifts by X meters, image is also shifts by X meters in opposite direction. If the object moves with X meters per second, image is also moves with X meters per second. Reverse, object is kept constant. If the mirror moves by x meters, right? Image is also moves by x meters. If the mirror moves with x meters per second, that is image moves by 2x meters per second, right? If the mirror is moving, if the mirror moves by x meters, image moves by 2x meters. If the mirror is moving with x meters per second, image is moving with double 2x meters per second. In the third case, right? Object and the mirror, both are moving opposite direction with x meters per second. Object is moving with x meters per second. Mirror is also moving with x meters per second. Image moves by 3x meters per second. If the object moves by x meters, mirror is also moves by x meters, then image moves by, what to say, 3x meters. Next, eighth one. To see full image, right? Mirror size is equals to half of the object size. Now mirror size is equals to half of the object size. Now these are the properties of the plane mirror.